very sexually excited during the show.
If you see Tom on the round of bummer, it's because we're watching Australian rules football in the back room.
Thank you.
attention, guys. I happen to really, really like the vagina. I think the vagina was made for those of us who are willing to respect it, to talk to it and treat it like another person.
Respect the cock.
Hey!
Unsettlement that we're having right now with the nation of China and America because we accidentally bumped into one of their airplanes. So this song is about the geopolitical condition in which we live today, and your part in it, and your place in the world. It goes like this.
Yeah.
could mark that one off.
Yeah.
You son of a bitch. This next song is a song that we wrote especially for you kids here tonight. It's for all you kids. You need grown-ups too.
Are there grown-ups here?
Yeah. Are there any grown-ups? Hello?
Because of the robber, we want you to know that we want to exploit your children.
We want to expose the children to words like fucking shit and things of that nature. Can we hear it, please? I want you all to scream fuck at the count of three. 1, 2, 3.
I got the word cocksucker.
Cocksucker's a good one. We'll go for cocksucker. 1, 2, 3.
Wait, let's try another one. How about dick, fuck, cunt, bloody ass.
Wait, what is it again?
Well, we can leave out the bunny ass part, that was just for effect.
Well, so what was it again?
How about dick fuck cunt?
Dick fuck cunt, ready? 1, 2, 3!
Go home and tell your parents what you don't do tonight, kids. Here's a song for you, it's really hard to play. Okay, how the fuck am I supposed to play when it's dark? Turn on the lights, please. Thank you.
Yeah.
spankings. Everybody knows about kids today, but parents in America don't really spank their kids anymore. And when I was a kid and I got in trouble, my parents would be like, take off your pants. I swear to God, this is a true story. I would have to take off my pants and my underwear, was sit in my room for like 15 minutes and wait for my dad to walk out with a belt this big. And then he would tip his pants and, no, just joking, that part didn't really happen, but he would really beat the shit out of me. And like, but now, parents really don't spank anymore. My point is really nothing. I really have no other reason but to vent to you because I used to get my ass kicked when I was a kid. But in turn, it made me write songs like this one, you know? Even though I'd get trouble, we'd come up with beautiful masterpieces just like this. If you want to sing, sing with us. It would be nice to have a fur job. It would be nice to have a fur job. It would be nice to have a fur job. It would be nice to have a fur job. It would be nice to have a fur job. It would be nice to have a fur job. It would be nice to have a fur job. It would be nice to have a fur job.
Thank you.
is about those special moments when you're all by yourself and you touch yourself where you got pee-pee because it feels good.
Who here has fun with their own body?
All these guys are like, fuck dude, I don't fucking masturbate. What the fuck dude? I got a chick for that kind of shit. I never touch my own wiener.
Liars. This song's for the liars.
Thank you.
I
want to dedicate this next song.
It hurt me inside.
I want to dedicate this next song to the two raddest, bestest, most awesomest, down-underest, STD-contractedest, raddest, pot-smokingest bands in the world, Motor Ace and Body Jaw. Give it up. I dedicate it to them because this song talks about the tour being over and tonight's the last night of our little tour. But the friendship lives on, man.
The friendship will live on, man.
The friendship will live on forever. What are we doing in life? Echoes in eternity.
I die alone.
emotional during that song.
Hey, I had tears running down my face because I got hair pulled up right into my eyes.
You think that Mark's really into the songs, but he's not. He's just crying because there's hair product in his eyes, you know?
Yeah. Till I get home.
Next song.
This next song is a big rock and roll jam. Guys like rock and roll out here?
Do you guys like that loud rock music?
You guys like that American style rock and roll? Because the hard rock and roll is still beating, man. That hard rock and roll just keeps on beating.
That stinker of rock and roll.
That's right. Here's the song. Travis starts it off and it goes like this.
Yeah.
see you, buddy. Did you enjoy the tour? Hold on.
This is Larry. I want some hi, Larry.
Hi.
Larry, what's your favorite part of the Vault Club?
Thank you.
cocksucker.
How many of you have a live record? Anybody? Okay. And you know damn good and well that this is not really our last song, but we're going to act like it, right?
And here's Larry again, with the fucking picks. Larry, always with the fucking picks and the guitars.
Oh, Larry.
All right, clap for Larry. Always up here, he's always on stage, always, hey, look at me, I'm Larry.
He grabbed my butt earlier.
I'm Larry, everybody, I'm...
Hey, so, when we finish the song, we'll go backstage and we will listen for a bunch of kids from Perth to say asshole over and over
again. No. I want them to chant for Larry after the song. Actually, you know what? I want you guys to chant, Larry loves Nick. Larry loves Nick. That's what you're going to chant after this last song, and then we'll come back out and play two more songs.
So everyone try it real quick. Larry loves Nick. Larry loves Nick.
Larry loves Nick.
All right. They're going to actually probably fall in love after this, and maybe we'll have a couple babies that have like five arms and 14 toes.
This has got 4 toes. Here we go.
Okay, wait, hold on. Nick, that was so funny.
It's really just where I buy time to the rest of my band members. I hope you're seeing you well. But we got some special songs for you, hold on. Thank you for asking us to come out here. Now's a great time to beat the traffic. You need to. Let me grab a guitar. Hold on 1 second, kids. This is a special song. I'm going to start playing it. Mark's going to come out here and sing it to you. This is a new song off our new record. That is finished. But, not out yet. Here we go.
When you fucked Grandpa, did he tell you that he loves you? Did he hold you till the sun did rise? And did he look into your eyes and ask you to fillet it and stick a finger or two in his ass? He is a total asshole. Grandfather is a total fucking asshole. Who would ever want a dirty, greasy finger in his ass?